to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back, no turning back. Turning the world behind me, the cross before me, the world behind me, the cross before me. Before me, no turning back, no turning back. I will follow you, Jesus. I will follow you, Jesus.
Still I will follow.
Though none go with me, still I will follow.
Though none go with me, still I will follow. No turning back, no turning back.
I still will follow.
No turning back, no turning back.
I will follow you, Jesus. I will follow you, Jesus. I will follow.
Will you decide now to follow Jesus?
Will you decide now to follow Jesus? No turning back, no turning back, no turning back, no turning back.
my feet and a light unto my bed.
Scripture reading for today is found in Matthew chapter 20, verses 1 through 16. Hear the word of the Lord. For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire workers for his vineyard. He agreed to pay them a denarius for the day and sent them into his vineyard. About 9 in the morning he went out and saw others standing in the marketplace doing nothing. He told them, "You also go and work in my vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right." So they went. He went out again about noon and about 3 in the afternoon and did the same thing. About 5 in the afternoon, he went out and found still others standing around. He asked them, "Why have you been standing here all day long doing nothing?" "Because no one has hired us," they answered. He said to them, "You also go and work in my vineyard." When evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Call the workers and pay them their wages, beginning with the last ones hired and going on to the first." The workers who were hired about 5 in the afternoon came and each received a denarius. So when those came who were hired first, they expected to receive more. But each one of them also received a denarius. When they received it, they began to grumble against the landowner. "These who were hired last worked only 1 hour," they said, "and you have made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the work and the heat of the day." But he answered one of them, "I am not being unfair to you, friend. Didn't you agree to work for a denarius? Take your pay and go. I want to give the one who was hired last the same as I gave you. Don't I have the right to do what I want with my own money? Or are you envious because I am generous?" So the last will be first, and the first will be last. This is the word of the Lord for the people of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
There once was a man who owned a vineyard and needed some men to work very hard. He hired some men early in the day and told them a denarius would be their pay. And every few hours he hired more men, telling them the same again and again. Then in the evening he gave them their wage, but the ones who came early expressed outrage. "We worked harder than anyone here. Aren't you being just a bit unfair?" "I'm not being unfair to you. A denarius was what you agreed to." You agreed to that. "Now take your pay and go. Even though you think it's low. For I'll be gracious to whom I want. I'll be generous even though you aren't. For many are victims of circumstance, and hiring you early was a matter of chance." There are Christians who live quite a long, long time, laboring all day, taking care of the vine. But some get saved after they are old, or live a short while after entering the fold. But nonetheless, on Judgment Day, both may end up receiving the same exact pay. For the point is not simply doing his biz, but rather revealing how gracious he is. Denarius. A denarius.
Hello, God bless you. My name is Ruben Rivera Martinez. I am the pastor of the United Methodist Church in Flanders. So I invite you to pray right now. Let us pray. Good and merciful God, We ask you to speak into our life through these words that we will share and reveal what you want to say to each one of us. We ask you, true God, to illuminate our path. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. I want to speak with you, sharing some words in this Sunday about the scripture of Matthew chapter 20, 1 through 16. And I take time to pray, I take time to meditate in this scripture. And when I be ready for writing this sermon, I put a title, and that title was Jesus Invite Us to Be Generous. When we prepare a sermon, we always ask ourselves, what is the scripture we have just read about? The question about the meaning of what has just been read for our life always goes through our head. You always think, how important is that I just read to me every day? I ask him to, what or how important is this read for my friends, for my neighbors, for my family? And today, we read in Matthew chapter 21 through 16, the question come back, what is about? What do this mean? How important is this to me? How important is this to my friends, to my family, to my church? And today, these questions spring to my mind again, based on the parable of the laborers in the vineyard. And I want you to ask yourself the same things. How important is this parable of the laborers in the vineyard to you, to your family, to your friends, to your neighbors, to your church? I think this is very, very important for all of us. How important is this parable of the laborers in the vineyard to you, to your family, to your church, to your neighbors? What teaching does this reading bring you today? What teaching you? What teaching your family? What teaching to your friends, to your neighbors, to your church? Every time you read this parable lively, it is like that Jesus will tell you something different from what he told you the last time. It is likely that each time you read Matthew chapter 20, 1 through 16, you will notice that the Lord speaks to you in a slightly different way. Every time that the Lord surprises you in such a way that that word you read a week ago, when you read it today, he wants to surprise you with something new. And that is why it is necessary that we ask ourselves the right questions Every time we read this passage or any other passage in the Bible, answering the main question that is none other than what is the parable of the laborers in the vineyards about. It seems to me that we must pay attention to the same thing matters. We must pay attention to the fact that the parable of the worker of the vineyard deals with the ninth and the tenth commitment. The ninth commitment tells us that we will not speak false testimony against our neighbors. And the tenth tells us that we cannot covet anything from our neighbors. This parable speaks directly against the greed. Against the greed. Perhaps covet may not seem the most obvious word to understand what is happening between the owner of the vineyard and the workers. The word greed is found at the heart of this parable in two ways. First, when we covet what God chooses to give others, the parables try to make us see ourselves in the story so that we can apply it in our daily lives. We must understand that when Jesus made this parable, it is to make his disciple understand and make us understand today that he is not talking about salary. He is not talking about to put money in the hands of the workers. No. Jesus is not talking about that, but that he is talking about forgiveness and salvation. Last week, the gospel reading was Matthew chapter 18, 23 to 35. And there we were told about forgiveness, and forgiveness is loving, and love is salvation. Today, the gospel again invites us to forgiveness and salvation. Invite us to understand that our Lord is merciful even to those who are late in the work. That our Lord wishes for each and every one of us the same thing, that we be saved. This is why we cannot look contemptuously at those who start late in the race. We cannot covet what has been given to others, because we will enjoy the same before the face of God. I want to say this again. This is why we cannot look contemptuously at those who started late in the race. We cannot covet what has been given to others, because we will enjoy the same before the face of God. And second, we must understand that greed is a problem when we believe that it's not fair that those who start later in the race receive the same award. It is not fair that they get the same as us because they do not deserve it. They are less worried for arriving later, because they are worse sinners. That is why they do not deserve the same as us. Those day laborers who arrived late did not deserve to be paid the same as the first ones. But in God's love, in God's justice, and in God's forgiveness, what we see and covet does not exist. In God's love, in God's justice, in God's forgiveness, what exists is to do what He wants with what is His. The questions that the owner of the vineyard asked, it's necessary to understand why God does they He does. It is lawful for me to do what I want with my own. The questions that the owner of the vineyard asked, it's necessary to understand why God does they does that way He does. It is lawful for me to do what I want with my own. As human, we are imperfect. And sometimes we have a habit for lusting and resenting what others receive from God. The owner of the vineyard asked those who have worked longer if it was bad for him to give back the way he understood that he had to give back. If they invite him the way he was good because he was generous. And it is necessary that today we understand that we cannot covet and resent what God gives to others. Because God's grace, mercy, and forgiveness are from God to give away when God deems it appropriate. These parables should remind us of that prophet who decided not to go to the place he was told to be gold, because that prophet understand that God was a merciful God, slow to anger, abundant in constant love, and willing to give into him time to punish. The name of this prophet was Jonah. He who had proclaimed that liberation belongs to the Lord, nevertheless, refused to allow others to receive it. However, God's purpose in the life of the people of Nineveh was fulfilled. It was not about what Jonah thought, about what Jonah coveted. It is not about what we think. It is not about what we coveted today. It is about what God wants to give by grace. It is about what God wants to give by grace. Today, the parable of the laborers in the vineyard reminds us that greed is not good. Today, the parable of the laborers in the vineyard remind us that God will be done no matter what. Today, the parable of the laborers in the vineyard tell us of our frustration with God's grace that applies not only to us, but to everyone else. Today, the parable of the worker in the vineyard reminds us that God's love is wonderful and that we cannot control it, that we are not the ones who distribute it. We are not the one who save. We are not the one there for the judge, but we are here to love. We are here to forgive. We are here to bless. And we are here to do justice. The parable of the laborers in the vineyard reminds us that we depend on God's generosity. We depend on that. We depend on God's generosity. Within the parable, the generosity of God is reflected. When the owner of the vineyard goes out to look for those workers who do not have land or goods, who only have the work of their hands, the parable reflects the way this worker lives, going from city to city, seeking their livelihood. This worker was seeking the favor of someone who would tell them to come and work. The parable teaches us what the kingdom of God is like. A kingdom that seeks the one in need. A kingdom that is approaching to us, approaching the one that needs to receive love, to receive forgiveness, to receive blessing, and to receive justice. Jesus himself reminds us what the kingdom of God is like. Jesus tells us the kingdom of heaven is like a man, the father of a family, who went out in the morning to hire worker for his vineyard. Jesus reminds us that God is looking for us. Jesus reminds us through this parable that our Lord watched over the well-being of each of one of us. Watch over our needs and supplies to our lives. The parable of the laborers in the vineyard reminds us that the first will be the last, and the last will be the first. What should remind us that the sun rises for everyone? That the reward that God has for you has it for others as well. The parable of the laborers in the vineyard reminds us that even though we start first and receive pay at the end of the day, we will receive the same as those who start last receive pay first. We will not receive less than others, but we will receive equally. God wants us to understand that we are all equal recipients of God's gifts. That we are not greedy, that we are not jealous because God will give us all in equal measures. I want to end with this testimony. During the year of 2017 and 2019, the Lord gave me the opportunity to travel to the country of Bolivia. There, I was able to see to a great extent what this parable of the vineyard is, of the laborer of the vineyard is. Because even there, the day laborers, the workers, gather in a specific place to wait for the owner of the farm, for the owner of the vineyard, goes group by group, selecting the people he wants to work in his vineyard, in his farm. And all workers, at the end of the day, no matter what time they start working, receive the pay they agree on. There I could see with my own eyes how work is paid for all who work in the vineyard, in the farm. This is what the Lord, how owns our life, call us. He called us to work because he will give us what we deserve. The retribution of the Lord is not like the retribution that the world gives. The retribution left by the Lord is not like that given by a man. The retribution that the Lord gives is the same for all. Equal love, equal justice, equal blessing, equal forgiveness. The parable of the labor in the vineyard reminds us that we have been called to bring the good news of salvation and make disciple of all nations. Please remember this. God has called you to give love. God has called you to give justice. God has called you to give blessing. God has called you to give forgiveness. God does not look for anything from you that you cannot do. No. He don't do that. God does not want us to be greedy of others. No. God wants to repay you in the same way that we will repay others. Remember, please, that God calls you always. Always, always God has called you to give love, to give justice, to give blessing, and to give forgiveness. That is what Jesus is teaching to us today. Don't forget that. Always. When you are going out of your house, out of your church, blessing others, love others, forgiving others, and please do justice for others. God bless you.
We overcome the enemy with the blood of Jesus and the word of our testimony, amen. This is my story.
If I told you my story,
you would hear hope that wouldn't let go. And if I told you my story, you would hear love that never gave up. And if I told you my story, you would hear life, but it wasn't mine. If I should speak, then let it be of the grace that is greater than all my sin. The wind does this for certain, and where mercy wins are the kindness of Jesus draws me in. Oh, to tell you my story is to tell the King. You sing this with us. This is my story.
I want to share with you the blessing for today. It's in the book of Numbers, chapter 6, verse 24 to 26. And read like this. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. God bless you. Blessing your family. Blessing your church. Blessing your neighbors. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.